The playoffs have begun. We are in the second round, and we've got 8 teams. None of them are from Canada. 5 of them have only been teams at all since 1991 or later. You know what that means? That means there's a lot of bandwagon fans. That means there's a lot of people who have no idea what's going on but want to. That also means there are a lot of people who are holding themselves back from hitting a loved one or a good friend in the face for asking what's going on and diverting your attention from the game during double OT sudden death in the playoffs. I decided it is about damn time somebody does a little bit of Lord Stanley's work and gives a minimal explanation about it. So here we go. So here we go. What the hell is hockey? The NHL has 31 teams. These 31 teams are broken up into 2 conferences. You've got the Eastern Conference and you've got the Western Conference. Each conference is then further broken up into 2 divisions. The Eastern Conference has the Metropolitan as well as the Atlantic divisions. The Western has got the Pacific and the Central divisions. The playoffs are made up of 16 teams. You've got the best 3 teams in each of those 4 divisions going in to 3 rounds, trying to find out who will play for the final round and hoist the Stanley Cup. Now, before anybody thinks I don't know my math, yes, the top 3 in 4 divisions is only 12 teams. So where do these other 4 teams come from? This is then what is called the wild card. Wild card teams are the 2 best teams in both of those conferences, regardless of the division that they are in. So you are going to have the 2 best teams that didn't make the cut from the Western Conference and the 2 best teams that didn't make the cut from the Eastern Conference. So that's where those other 4 teams come from. There are 2 teams made up of 5 skaters on the ice and 1 goalie. The lines are 3 on offense, 2 guys on defense, plus the goalie. How do they know when to get off the ice? They are not wearing little earphones. They are not getting some little like signal in some hidden thing. Every time the player steps on the ice with their line, shifts have begun. A shift is the amount of time that that particular line or that crew is on the ice, and they are usually about 45 seconds. Why do they only play for that short of a time? The heart rate maxes out after 45 or more seconds because, if you didn't already know, fastest sport on earth. These guys are giving it all. Heart rate maxes out. Once they hit about 40 seconds on the ice, that is when they start looking for an opportunity to switch out and let the next line on. Whether it be an opportunity where the puck is cleared, or it be a whistle is blown, or it be that they've got a drive going and that is the most opportune time to get the next group out, that is when they will do so. In some cases, they have 1 player who is leading that line who will be the first to start to make the move, and they are very much aware of what is going on. So no, there are no hidden earpieces, there are no secret code words yelled, and there are no stoppage of play in order to switch a line. Number 2, what is an icing? An icing is when a team that is on defense clears the puck from behind the center line and it travels all the way down the ice and crosses over the opposing team's blue line. Meaning, you're on defense, you want to get the puck out of there, you can ice it, you send it across, nobody touches it, it crosses red and crosses blue. That means there will be a stoppage in play, the puck will be then taken back to the zone it was cleared from, and they will have a face-off. How come the goalie leaves? Pulling the goalie is a tactic used when a team is looking to get 1 more skater on the ice in a last-minute attempt to try and either tie or win the game. They will pull the goalie, and as soon as the goalie gets off, they will throw another skater on, making it so that they have 6 players on the ice able to take shots on net rather than 5. Does it always work? No. And does it sometimes end up in an empty net goal? Yeah. It's just another tactic. What does it mean to be on a power play? What does it mean to be shorthanded? If a team has a penalty issued to them, meaning somebody did something wrong, they will then be issued a penalty. The player who caused the problem will be directed to sit in the penalty box for a total of 2 minutes, which would be a minor, or 5 minutes, which would be a major. During this time, their team is going to be shorthanded. They are going to be down one player, and they're on what is called the penalty kill, as in they are trying to kill the time that they are shorthanded without allowing a single goal. What is a power play? A power play means you're on the other team. You're the team that didn't do something wrong. So you get the advantage by having another man on the ice. No, it's not an additional man. It's just that you are now facing four rather than five. What are common penalties? Well, you've got the penalties that are just game things, like a delay of game. A delay of game can be when a player hucks the puck and it goes over the glass. Something like having too many men on the ice because there was a problem during a line change. And then there are penalties that are just because somebody's just being a jerk, such as hooking, meaning you take your stick and you hook somebody's leg, tripping. Or you've got, everybody knows now, the old cross check. It's when you don't have your stick on the ice and you're holding it up like this and you use the shaft with two hands on it to hit the other player. Two hands on the shaft, that's also what she said. Now, if at the end of these 3 20-minute periods the game is tied, it will go into overtime. The overtime in the Stanley Cup playoffs is a little bit different than the overtime during the regular season. So, no, I'm sorry, you will not be seeing any shootouts during the Stanley Cup playoffs. The playoffs will have a 20-minute sudden-death overtime, and they will have as many as they need to have. That means it's essentially just one more period, 20 minutes, 5v5, but whoever scores first wins. It ends right there. So it can go as long as 19 minutes, or somebody could score within the first 10 seconds and it will be over. So that is part one of What the Hell is a Hockey. I'm going to have follow-up videos. I'm going to do 90 seconds of bandwagon fan for each particular team. I'm going to tell you, who do you care about? I'm going to tell you, what do you have to lose? You know what? I'm even going to tell you how to pronounce those ridiculous last names so that you can even further enjoy all of this. And you'll be able to get all of this information in less time than there is between periods. So check all those out. I hope that this video helped at least somebody make it so that they can watch this game. Also hope that this video makes it so that nobody ever has to miss anything because they need to explain. Individual team videos will be up very shortly. Thank you guys for watching. If you have liked what you've seen, please hit subscribe. If you don't like what you've seen, I hope that you'll throw a little comment in there. And I will see you guys for the next video. In the meantime, as always, let's go Rangers!